thousands of years ago, when the sun was believed to circle the earth. Long before Charak, Aryabhatta, Sushruta, Newton, Hippocrates or Socrates, in the land of the monsoon, amidst lush forests, grew a tenacious plant. Not to be bullied by the tall trees of the evergreen forest, it sought the sun. Throughout determined little roots, climbed high. Its pungent aroma announced its presence, bold and enticing. It attracted humans, who then turned to plants for food, shelter, even healing and protection. Its fame spread across shores, across continents. This is the story of black pepper, the undisputed king of spices. What the fabled apple is to the world of science, pepper is to world history. Its impact on civilization, huge. Wars have been fought, kingdoms overthrown, oceans braved, continents discovered, nations colonized, all for the sake of the black gold. The King of Spices has an enticing story.
Black gold or black pepper, its influence in history, global history, is unparalleled. The flavor and the fragrance of this spice had a magic spell in human civilization and culture since very ancient days.
Western Ghats, running along the west coast, hotspot of amazing biodiversity, cradle of spices. Pepper grows here in abundance, its humidity and heat making it a perfect home for the pungent spice. On Pepper Trail, we are headed some 30 kilometers from Mangalore. Mudabidri is a small town steeped in culture and spices. On a cool, crisp winter night, Yakshagana artists don their costumes and makeup, transforming themselves into characters from the Puranas. The animated theatre form has kept mythology alive. These night-long performances, an unbroken ritual. As the night makes way for the morning, we reach a pepper farm. Green vines curled along coconut and areca trees. Woody vines soaring high, their tenacious roots clinging to the rough tree trunks, large, shiny, leathery leaves. On these tall climbers grow clusters of beads, hard and green. Bunches of black pepper hang like grapes, unripe berries. Piper nigrum to botanists, black pepper belongs to the Piperaceae family of plants. The name pepper comes from a Sanskrit word, pippali, meaning berry. The Sanskrit roots natural because pepper originated in India. Its cultivation today confined to the three southern states of our country. This part of Karnataka is called Malenadu, the land of hills. It's a cool January morning. Life on this spice farm tuned to the rhythms of nature. Few berries on the pepper vine have turned red. A signal. It's time to harvest. Picking of berries is a task perfected over generations. With bags tied to their waists, the harvesters climb high. Each bunch is to be hand-picked. Only the bigger, bolder berries are plucked. The air itself, flavored with the tantalizing aroma of fresh pepper. A single stem bears 20 to 30 fruiting spikes. The berries need to be plucked before the fruit is fully mature and still hard. If allowed to ripen, it will lose pungency. Each vine produces nearly 100 kilograms of fresh pepper each year. Picking would spread over the next 3 months. As the workers take a well-deserved tea break, we cannot but turn back the pages of history. There was a time when pepper was so rare that it was worth its weight in gold. So rare that the world was besotted with its flavor and medicinal properties. Counted corn by corn as currency, it defined richness. Rents and dowries were paid with pepper. In France, just a pound of peppercorns could free a slave. Sailors had to have their pockets stitched lest they stole the valuable spice. Fierce warrior Attila the Hun captured Rome in the 5th century. He demanded 3,000 pounds of pepper as ransom. Such was its value and demand. In the age of exploration, Spanish monarchs Isabella and Ferdinand commanded Christopher Columbus to sail to the land of pepper. Columbus sailed westward, discovered America. Portuguese sailor Vasco da Gama chose a different route. He crossed the west coast of Africa, round the Cape of Good Hope. By this time, half his crew was dead. Determined to succeed, Vasco da Gama reached Calicut in 1498. He had found India, the land of pepper.
The history of India would have been a different one had not Vasco da Gama landed. In fact, this is a singular event which sowed the seeds of colonialism in Asia and many other African countries during the subsequent 2 centuries that followed this event.
On the trail of the spice that led to our colonization. Time to discover how the red and green corns, the freshly picked mature berries, become the black spice as we know it. Berries from each bunch are separated. Shades of red and green. Each bunch a twisted spiral, yielding 40 to 50 berries. Hands, feet, machine, each working in practiced symphony. The smooth-skinned green beads are moist and need to be dried. Tied in jute sacks, the berries are plunged into boiling water just a minute. Not more, not less.
So we dip it in the boiling water for 1 minute so that only the skin is killed, that green matter is killed. The kernel shouldn't get heated. So then spread it out in the yard for drying.
Blanching for a minute hastens the drying, makes the skin of the berry stick to the kernel. But not all pepper is blanched. Many cultivators prefer to directly dry it in the sun. White pepper is also made from these green corns. Left to ferment for a few days, the seed coat is removed. Washed 3 to 4 times, these are also sun-dried. Black or white. As they dry, the outer skins, the pericarp turns thick, now dark and pungent, wrinkled. From 100 kilograms of green berries, about 35 kilograms dry black pepper can be obtained. The spice with a personality. bold and interesting. In the kitchen, pepper adds a zing to many recipes. In this potato fry, center stage is pepper.
काली मिर्च ऐसा मसाला है कि जिसको न डालें तो वो मसाला अधूरा रहता है ये हर मसालों की जान है काली मिर्च इस आलू का श्रेय जाएगा सिर्फ काली मिर्च को जाएगा
Pepper adds a distinct punch to many food items in Indian and international cuisine. Many recipes unimaginable without it.
उसका एक टेस्ट ही रहता है वो मिर्ची जैसा है तो एक घाटपन आता है उसके अंदर वही है
Soups, salads, rasams, cutlets, both vegetarian and non-vegetarian dishes. In lentils and high-protein dishes, pepper occupies a distinct place. In the Indian garam masala mix, pepper is indispensable. Pepper, a spice immortalized in history. Black peppercorns were found stuffed in the nostrils of Rameses II, used for mummification. Father of medicine, Hippocrates, he prescribed pepper for a host of ailments, ranging from colds and coughs to an antidote to poison. In Ayurveda, pepper or maricha occupies a place of honor, used liberally in a range of formulations.
आयुर्वेद में एक तरह से ऑमनीपोटेंट है मरीच लगभग हर एक जो पॉली हर्बल और पॉली मिनरल कॉम्बिनेशन जो आयुर्वेद में डिस्क्राइब किया गया है उसमें मरीच को आप पाएंगे मरीच को अगर निकालेंगे तो आप आयुर्वेद में कुछ ज़्यादा मेडिसिन नहीं पाएंगे इट इज़ द स्पाइस ऑफ आयुर्वेद इफ यू हैव टू लेबल इट
द स्पाइस ऑफ आयुर्वेदा पेपर इज नोन टू बी हॉट एंड पंजेंट इट्स एक्शन Swift and precise. One must remember, black pepper was the main pungent spice known to India till the advent of chili some 500 years ago. Traditional knowledge of spices thrives in homes and home kitchens. It's passed down generations. A mix of jaggery and pepper is Jamuna Thai's preferred mix.
आमच्या इकडं म्हणजे दवाखाना नाही आहे मग तो असा पोट दुखायला लागला कोणला काय झाला जरासा म्हणजे त्रास झाला मग तो थोडासा गरम पाणी द्यावाचा गरम पाणी दिल्याने त्याला ढेकर येतात ढेकर आल्याने त्याचा काय असेल ते थोडासा बरं वाटते
द गुडनेस ऑफ टेस्ट कपल्ड विथ बेटर हेल्थ दॅट्स व्हॉट स्पायसेस डू मिक्सिंग स्पायसेस टुगेदर इन प्रिसाईज वेज The skill of folk medicine and cooking. Urad dal or black gram is considered heavy, difficult to digest. Is that why traditionally urad papads always have black pepper in them?
So paijun na papad so paijun. Kajayan masala ta amiti taktu. So vila.
But it's never just taste. Pepper makes heavy proteins easy on the stomach, helping digestion. In biochemistry laboratories, the amazing chemical makeup of pepper is being analyzed. The pungent molecule of pepper, its principal compound is piperine. This molecule makes up 5 to 10% weight of all peppercorns. Piperine gives pepper its health properties, aroma and taste, making it the corn that calls out to us. Piperine is a light and highly volatile molecule. It rises in the air and tickles our nose. But why is piperine good for us? The answer lies in its amazing properties and action. Like all spices, it kills harmful germs effectively. A powerful antioxidant, it scavenges free radicals, reduces inflammation and clears disease pathways. Promotes digestion by increased digestive juices. But what makes pepper truly special is its one specific action, bioavailability.
Mine was a very specific discovery on a small quantity of black pepper extract. Piperin has the unique ability to increase the gastric absorption of food items.
We are what we eat, an age-old saying. But would it not be more accurate to say, we are what we absorb? Here's how pepper works on our food and body. Our digestive tract is responsible for breakdown of food, absorption of nutrients, and removal of toxins. Scientists have discovered that when pepper is added to food, the nutrients become stable and available. They are retained in the body and not thrown out. What is even more interesting is the finding that piperin even enables medicines to work better.
I'll just give you an example. You think you have just taken 100 milligram, you have gotten the benefit of 100 milligram vitamin C. In reality, you probably would absorb 20 milligram. The remaining 80 milligram will go through the fecal matter.
In animal trials and controlled studies, new possibilities are emerging. Piperine added in precise quantities in modern drugs may help in making them more effective, more available, less toxic. The corn that had the world going in circles, pepper, is deeply embossed in colorful stories. One goes like this. During the height of the Portuguese trade, when shiploads of pepper sailed out from Calicut into the world, when India enjoyed complete monopoly over pepper, some greedy merchants started plundering pepper wines. The growers of black pepper ran in alarm to their king, the Zamorin of Calicut. The unruffled Zamorin said, "Let them. Can the Portuguese take with them that last monsoon rain? Can they take our soil?" The Zamorin was right. Without the monsoon and the soil of Kerala, there could be no pepper. The hot and humid Western Ghats, 250 rainy days in a year. Soil neither dry nor waterlogged. Pepper is a choosy plant. Its shallow roots seeking nutrition from the earth. Its climbing roots taking it upward. Its flowers appear in spikes, pollinated by raindrops or gravity. Some 9 months later, the berries appear. Their boldness and size dependent on the soil and weather.
ಮೆಣಸಿನ ಬೀಳು ಒಂದು ಜೀವ ಇರೋ ಪದಾರ್ಥ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್? ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಸಾಕ್ದಂಗೆ ಸಾಕಂಡ್ರೆ ಅರ್ಧ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ.
ಪೆಪಾ ಡೊಮೆಸ್ಟಿಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್ ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ 6,500 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಗೋ, ಚೋಸನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ಸೆಸ್ಟರ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಗೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಪೆಪಾ ಗ್ರೋಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓವರ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಡ್ ಟು ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ to lead to bolder varieties and better yield.
ಇದು ಮೆಣಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ವಿಶೇಷ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಮೊದಲು ಸ್ಪ್ರೌಟ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ರೂಟ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ.
This is how pepper begins its life on the nearly 120,000 hectares of land in India. Our yearly production, about 65,000 tons. But all is not well. The tall medicinal plant with its shallow roots has not been able to protect itself from pathogens, disease, and pests. The scientific community has taken the problem head on. Pepper, one of the principal mandate crops of Indian Institute of Spices Research, a multidisciplinary team of scientists tackling the virus attacks, developing resistance, identifying the root-piercing nematodes, and suggesting measures against it.
So, what we are trying to do the research is at sustainable level. We have to live with the nature, we have to conserve our biodiversity, at the same time produce more.
From cutting-edge biotechnology to simple selection of cuttings, Farmers and scientists are learning to choose and develop varieties suitable for climatic and soil conditions. Better resistance to disease and pest, better yield and pungency. This research, aided by the living germplasm, maintained at an IISR field station, one of the largest of this kind anywhere in the world. Wild varieties of pepper collected from forests are here. So are the cultivated varieties from all over the world. Each variety offering a different set of characters encoded in its genes.
Why it is needed? If we want a particular trait of importance, we look back into the germplasm collections. You can design your crop of the traits what you want.
Each plant promises an opportunity. One could offer better yield, another earlier fruiting, another disease resistance, and yet another a better root system. All these characteristics encoded in their genes. With careful selection and crossbreeding, scientists are able to design better hybrid varieties. A potted variety of pepper that fruits round the year has been successfully developed already. Bush pepper does not need to climb tall trees but grows in pots. It fruits through the year. Another one is column pepper, a variety that climbs not tall trunks but specially devised nutrient-filled columns. It fruits early and is easy to harvest. Pepper is our legacy, a rich, colorful past, a vibrant present, and a future that looks great. India exports nearly 12,000 tons of black pepper each year. The king of spices continues to rule the international spice trade with a 1/4 share. Pepper means something to each one of us. As a powerful home remedy, as a special zing to our food, the call of the corn, powerful and beckoning even today. Do send us your reactions and feedback by email or post. Our address: Vigyan Prasar, A50, Institutional Area, Sector 62, Noida 201309. Our email: info@vigyanprasar.gov.in.